So there's one more comment from my video the other day that I want a response to. My biggest problem is being way too hard on myself when something doesn't go right, especially when I've done it right before. We like to do that, don't we? Be hard on ourselves. Not just musicians, but people.
Everybody.
And it's especially frustrating when you know you can do something, but for some reason, in the moment, it's just not working. And I guarantee 100% that absolutely every musician who has ever lived has at one point or another experienced this, regardless of how good they are. So what's going on here, if it's so common? Obviously, I can't speak for the musicians who lived hundreds of years ago, or the musicians in other cultures. But I think in the West, there is definitely this big emphasis on success, on prestige, on progress, on goals. Mastery and excellence are words that get used a lot.
Command performance. I mean, geez.
Let me be clear that there's nothing wrong with success necessarily, or with having goals or wanting to get better. But sometimes in the phrase, I want to be better, or I know I'm better, or they're better than me, there's this almost violent rejection of myself as I am right now. Who I am right now is not good enough and has to be better. Which I think musicians are trained to think sometimes. Here's where I am, where I can't do the thing, and over there is where I want to be, where I can do the thing, and this is not what I want, that's what I want. Which on some level makes sense. But the thing is that even if we do move from here to over there, we take that feeling of rejection with us. That feeling doesn't stay here while I stand up and move over here. It's like, no, I'm carrying that feeling. So no matter where I'm standing, I'm still not good enough. I still need to be better. The past couple of years, I've used this alternative. I'm not out here to master the trumpet or to conquer all of music. Rather, I'm out here to explore. When I get up and start practicing each morning, for me, it's not so much about trying to get better. Instead, it's about trying new things. It's about going places in my playing and my music that I've never gone before. It's also about revisiting old places and seeing if the landscape has changed in any way. And in exploring all of these things, I will grow. I will get better. Will I get frustrated? Oh yes. Will I wake up one day and not be able to do something that I was able to do yesterday? Oh yeah. I just spent the past couple of days trying to figure out articulation again, and I spent like months of this last year working on that. And if I go about addressing these things in such a way where it's like, I need to get better, I need to get my playing in line, I'm gonna burn out pretty fast, and I'm not really gonna wanna practice, even if I deep down love playing the trumpet. But if I approach a problem in my playing with curiosity instead, as in, ooh, that's an interesting sound. I was able to do that yesterday. What's going on? What happens if I try it this way? Ooh, still not working. This is unknown territory. I don't know what I'm supposed to do next. I find that if I take a step back and approach things with curiosity, even the feeling of frustration that I inevitably feel, suddenly it's as if there's not negative thoughts or positive thoughts or good at trumpet or bad at trumpet. There's just mystery. For a conqueror, the unknown is intimidating and threatening. For an explorer, the unknown may be scary, but it's also kind of exciting. So, as much practice as we have being critical of ourselves, I do think that at any moment we can pause, look around, and get curious about the inner workings of our thoughts, our instruments, our music, and even our creativity.